We're going to look at a few more exercises on two independent sample t-test. We've already covered this section. So in our previous video, we tested the impact of gender on all the scores, whether in fact gender has an impact on the score or not. A further exercise that we want to cover in this short video is on the car sales data. So we've got the car sales data over here, and we have information regarding various cars. We've got model information, the manufacturer, what was the price, the engine specs, the horsepower, wheelbase, length, etc., the fuel capacity and the mileage. We also have a variable which tells us what type of car is it. It's a binary variable 0 and 1. It means is it an SUV or not. What we have to do in this exercise is test if the type of car impacts the mileage of the car and whether the type of car impacts the horsepower. So remember, this is a binary variable, 0 and 1. So essentially what it does is it divides our sample into two subsamples, a sample A, which is your SUVs, and sample B, which is the non-SUV cars. And the fact that we have to we are testing over here is, does the type of car impact any other parameter such as mileage? So in a two sample t-test, we've already covered the null hypothesis that the two samples are drawn from the same mean, i.e. type of car does not impact the mileage, and the alternative hypothesis would be that type of car does impact the mileage and the two samples are coming from different populations. So I'm going to look at this data set. It's already imported in SAS over here. It's in my data library over here, car underscore sales. I've got type as a binary variable, and I've got the fuel capacity and mileage. So I'm going to test mileage, which is the miles per gallon variable over here. The procedure is simple. I just type in proc t-test data equal to data dot car underscore sales. In the class variable, I have to give the categoric variable which is creating the two samples. In the car sales dataset, we are testing it whether the fact that it's an SUV or not, which is given by the type variable. So I copy and type and put it into the class option over here. The variable which I'm testing, or the impact of type on the variable which I'm testing. So in our first, we have to check for mileage. Mileage is given by the MPG variable, miles per gallon. And that's it. Press run. And we can do ODS HTML to get an HTML output. And we've got a subsection as well. We want to test whether horsepower is impacted as well. So I can either copy this and write another procedure, or I can actually write the variable, second variable, in the same statement over here. So I'm going to do that. So I'm going to copy the horsepower variable. Spelling is just still horsepower, and put it over here, and I'm going to select it, press F3, and I get the result. I click on result viewer, and there we have the impact of type on miles per gallon. Look at the t-test, unequal variances. I see the p-value is very, very, very small. It's less than 0.0009. The t-value, as you can see, is way out into the rejection region over here. So we can, in fact, reject the null hypothesis. As you can see over here, we've got 113 as type 0 observations. We've got 40 as type 1 observations. The mean for 1 is 19.7. The mean for 0 is 25.35. So it seems that the cars which are SUVs, 1 stands for an SUV, is much lower than non-SUVs, and which makes sense. The mileage for SUVs is lower than non-SUVs. And this difference, more importantly, this difference between the two types of cars, the two types of samples, is highly significant. Right? Now, the next part of our question was, does horsepower also impact? And here we see that the horsepower variable, the average horsepower of an SUV is 186.4. The average horsepower for a non-SUV is 184.6. There is a difference of roughly about 2 horsepower between these two. And is that difference significant? As you can see in the p-value over here, that difference is coming out to be insignificant, i.e. The average horsepower is not impacted by whether the car is an SUV or not in this particular data set that we are working with, and which is again a very interesting result. One would have thought that it does impact, and maybe even this difference of 2 horsepower is significant, but what it's saying over here is that SUVs, though they are slightly look to be slightly higher in horsepower than non-SUVs, but this difference is not statistically significant. As you can see, the p-value is about 0.83. Now I'm going to do the same exercise on SPSS. I've already got the data set imported. To check the impact of SUV on the two variables, I need to go to analyze. I need to go to compare means. This is an independent samples t-test. Again, because SUV and non-SUV are two separate samples, there's no overlap between them. The variable that I'm testing is miles per gallon. Oops, I see miles per gallon has been coded off as a nominal variable over here. I'm going to the variable view, change MPG into a scale variable. Come back, analyze, compare means, independent samples t-test, select horsepower, and select miles per gallon, bring it in. The grouping variable is type, and the two groups that we have got are 0 and 1. Continue. Press OK. And there we get. So this is the test for equality of variances, but I've already covered. When in doubt, always go with equal variances not assumed. So let's look at equal variances not assumed for the t-test. For horsepower, as you can see, the p-value is coming out to be 0.834. And if we compare this with the SAS value, it will be exactly the same. 0.834, i.e. we're going to reject the null hypothesis. Now let's look at the miles per gallon variable, and the p-value is coming to be effectively 0.000, i.e. there is a difference between the mean, and that difference is highly significant. So horsepower is not impacted by the type of car, but mileage is impacted, and that was the exercise for independent samples t-test.